screen, trick or treat, magic fills the air. The pumpkin festival started, autumn colors everywhere. Ghouls and ghosts and goblins grin from ear to ear. Oh look, a Mickey Mouse pumpkin, happy Halloween time is pumpkin. Happy Halloween time is here.
Happy Halloween time is here.
Thank you much. How fun if you enjoyed our show today. We're on the Dapper Dans of Disneyland. But hey, if you did enjoy our show, we are Cirque du Soleil.
Hello, folks. Welcome aboard the Disneyland Railroad. We're now embarking on a grand circle tour of the Magic Kingdom, with stops at New Orleans Square, Mickey's Toontown, and Tomorrowland, followed by a visit to the Grand Canyon and Primeval World. We got a lot of traveling ahead of us, so remember, for a safe trip, you need to stay seated, keeping your hands, arms, feet, and legs inside the train. And please, watch your children. Uh-oh. Did you folks hear that? Sounds to me like we've reached the wilds of Adventureland, where you just might run into a lot of savage critters out there, including lions and tigers and tiki birds. Everybody best be on the lookout. You never know just what may show up. We're approaching our first stop, New Orleans Square Station. This station serves Frontierland, New Orleans Square, and Critter Country. If you leave leaving us here, please remain seated until the train comes to a complete stop. Then watch your step while getting off. Have a good time in the Frontier here. For those of you continuing on this, we'll be resuming our trip in just a moment. This is New Orleans Square.
New Orleans Square, folks. Your stop for Critter Country, Adventureland, Frontierland, and New Orleans Square attractions. All the great food, great music, and Jack Skellington to go
around. Yeah, I wanted to go all the way around.
Oh, okay.
Please remain seated until we come.
That way. Right now, as we travel back in time, back to the fantastic primeval world, land of the dinosaurs.
Oh! My name is Emily, and I will be your captain and storyteller today.
And to Storybook Land.
On our left-hand side, we have the cave of the Big Bad Wolf, and right across the way, we have the homes of the three little pigs. One made of straw, one made of sticks, and one made of 100% wolf-proof bricks. English Village, where Alice from Alice in Wonderland is from. She often likes to daydream by the river, but one day she followed a white rabbit, and they both fell down, down, down into Wonderland. Straight ahead, we have the city of Agrabah, the city of mystery and enchantment. High up top is the Sultan's Palace, and down below is the busy, busy marketplace, where Aladdin not only stole bread and apples, but Princess Jasmine's heart as well. Now please remain seated and do not touch anything, for we're about to enter the Cave of Wonders, where everything is enchanted. As Aladdin found out, there is one treasure more precious than the rest.
Yeah.
It is that magic lamp containing its very own genie. To our left, we have the French Chateau, where Cinderella grew up with her wicked stepmother and two evil stepsisters. On that winding path there, you can still see the pumpkin carriage she took all the way up top to meet her Prince Charming at the ball. To our left, we have the three Dutch mills. The one in the middle is the one that housed all those animals in the harsh winter storm, and the Silly Symphony is the old mill. Straight ahead underneath those snowy mountains is the alpine village where Pinocchio is from. That wood carving shop by the river is where Geppetto made his first wish upon a star and turned Pinocchio into a real boy.
Ole! Ole! It's joke time!
All the birds sing words
and the flowers grow.
And now, senors and senoritas, please place your eyes into the center of the room that is. We present the enchanted fountain.
Ach, yeah! And a wunderbar birdmobile, which has birds on it, and it goes round and round. And that's why we call it a birdmobile.
Look, here come the girls.
Madame and monsieur, if it is in the communities of your soul, just let the folder share with all each other.
I wonder what happened to Rosita.
I get paid for the amount of people I take out, not bring back. Yes, all right, please. All right. Well, guys, look over there on your left. That is a Bengal tiger. Wow. Hey, can you guys tell me why tigers have stripes? Does anyone know? Because they don't want to be spotted. Look up ahead, folks. See that archway right there? That's actually Disneyland's first attempt at the monorail. Didn't really work out, but it does make a nice little entryway into our sacred Indian elephant bathing pool. And look at this, guys. Looks like the whole herd is here today. Wow. Hey, so can anyone tell me how you can tell these are Indian elephants? Like, how you tell the difference between an Indian elephant and an African elephant? Does anyone know? No? It's their ear size. They're smaller. What, you guys thought there was a joke in there? No, you're going to learn something today, guys. Yes, the more you know. Oh, no. They're going bananas, guys. Look at that. Oh, no. One more banana joke? Let's play. Yeah. The tall ones over there. Giraffe, close. They're called long-necked cheetahs. They're very similar to giraffes. Yeah. Oh, look at this, guys. The lions are protecting that sleeping zebra. Oh, you know what? He looks dead tired. Let's let him rest in pieces. Look over here, guys. See, this is why you don't argue with a rhino. They always get their point across. Hey, I bet you guys don't see that every day. But I do.